Hello and welcome to ONE Championship's Manila event, One Dawn of Heroes. I'm Mitch Chilson, alongside the former world champion and current vice president of ONE Championship, Miss Misha Tate. Misha, how pumped are you for this card?
Oh my God, I can't wait. I've literally been getting goosebumps thinking about this all day. I can't wait. Two of my favorite American athletes, obviously on this card, DJ and Eddie. But man, that matchup between Eddie Alvarez and Eduard Folayang has been giving me chills all week. But it's not just that. I mean, we have a great main event, great co-main, the whole card, stacked, top to bottom. I'm thrilled.
The prelims, oh man, the prelims are jumping off the page. Ladies and gentlemen, you have got to check out this event. We have a stacked card from top to bottom. It is not to be missed. We have over 140 martial arts world champions on the roster of ONE Championship, and 11 of them are here with us tonight competing in Manila, Philippines, including the ONE Featherweight world champion, Martin Nguyen. We've also got Jehe Eustaquio, Anario Benario from the legendary Team Lakai, and we've also got Leandro Issa, the BJJ world champion, ready to throw down in the co-main event for the Flyweight Muay Thai World Championship. The general, Jonathan Haggerty, defends his strap against Rodtang Jitmuangnon, and Martin Nguyen is back to defend his Featherweight World Championship against one of the toughest Japanese athletes out there, Koyomi Matsushima. This is going to be a huge main event, and I cannot wait for this Featherweight title tilt.
Since training at Hard Knocks 365, I feel like I've evolved so much more as an athlete. Tonight's bout, I feel so much more confident. I feel so much more dangerous than my last bout against Shadamba. And Matsushima will find out when we both enter that ring.
Oh, Misha, what do you think? Martin Nguyen, he has that power bomb of a right hand, but it's more than just power. There's a science to it, isn't there?
There is, you know. I mean, it looks like he's slinging rocks from his back pocket, but you know what? He's one of the most technical with that overhand right. I am a huge fan of the overhand right, and Martin Nguyen probably has one of the best overhand rights I have ever seen. The knockout power that comes behind that, and his setups, the way that he'll kick, he will disguise it. He doesn't just throw it to throw it. I mean, it has bad intentions.
It does, and he is just so entertaining to watch, ladies and gentlemen. He's got a big matchup on his hands. Koyomi Matsushima has also got that legit one-punch KO power, but he loves to wrestle.
Yeah, he mixes it up really well. He's a master of kicks from his karate background, but you know, he's also incredibly talented at mixing everything together. Very dynamic. I was so impressed with his chain wrestling, and he's got a powerful check right hook as well. So he's got knockout power in his hands. I mean, he's very dangerous, very well-rounded.
It's gonna be a good matchup for the Featherweight title. You do not want to miss it. Martin Nguyen defends his belt against Koyomi Matsushima in the main event. But if we look at the general, when he won his Flyweight Muay Thai title against Samae Gyeonghidao in a spectacular event, he actually called out Rodtang. How often do you see a champion call out his next challenger, Misha?
Well, I mean, it says a lot that he called out Rodtang, right? I mean, it means that he really wants to test himself, because as a champion, you always want the next best person, right? Because the next best person is going to push you to be your best and to show your best attributes. And Rodtang is that person. I mean, I can't tell you, when I see him get hit with punches and then he hits himself in the face and he just comes forward anyways, it's like, this guy is next level. So very exciting.
Let's hear more about what Haggerty has to say about his big matchup.
So for some people, he could be a nightmare for some people, but for me, he's my perfect opponent in like coming forward. That's what I like. I like my opponents coming forward so they can walk onto shots, and I can work off of him and work around him and just run circles around him, really. That's the plan.
That's what Haggerty does best. He disguises everything. His setups are beautiful. His feints are brilliant. The way his setups kind of work, it's like he's a magician, confusing you and dazzling you with what's going on over here, but then he hits you over here.
Yeah,
it is,
you know,
so beautiful.
I think both of these guys are pressure style athletes, but Haggerty has a totally different way of doing this than Rodtang does. Haggerty really uses his push kicks and he uses his punches in combination. He sets everything up perfectly. He's very methodical, but he has a way of pressing forward with that thought behind it. There's always a reasoning. You know, he's not a brawler. He's very much a technician.
Now, what about the challenger, Rodtang Jitmuangnon, the Iron Man? This guy is pure excitement. You can just feel the adrenaline jumping out of the circle every time he competes. But he's more than just a brawler. He's got technique too.
Rodtang is a competitor. He comes to compete, and the more damage that he takes, it's almost like the more dangerous he gets. So there's really no quit in him. You know, he's more of a brawler, but you know, he's methodical in his own way. He pushes forward, he drives. I mean, he really has an overwhelming, powerful style when he gets in the circle and competes. It's very exciting to watch.
These two are gonna go at it, and there's big, big stakes at hand here in Manila. We've got the one flyweight Muay Thai world title on the line, but don't forget about the flyweight world Grand Prix. We've got the semifinals coming up tonight. We've got the 12-time mixed martial arts world champion Demetrious Johnson going up against Tatsumitsu Wada. Let's hear more from what this highly experienced, the best pound-for-pound athlete has to say about his matchup coming up.
Obviously, taking on another Japanese athlete, coming out of the same gym, Tokyo Tribe, so I'm sure it's going to be tough because I fought one of them already, so they kind of know my style. But I'm looking forward to it. You know, it's a fight. I think it's going to be a great competition. I'm looking forward to going out there. I just want Japan not to hate me if I get through this one, too.
Demetrious Mighty Mouse Johnson, most likely the best pound-for-pound mixed martial artist on the planet Earth, and he is truly something special. The way this guy gets it done is just magic.
He's incredible, and I don't know how anybody could hate such a nice human being, but you know, he is one of the most exciting athletes to watch. They call him Mighty Mouse, but I call him the GOAT. To me, he is the greatest of all time. So, you know, a big challenge here tonight he has in front of him with Wada, but you know, he's been there, he's seen a lot of it before, so I'm very excited to see him get out there and do what DJ does best.
See, to me, it's gonna be interesting to see you break down Tatsumitsu Wada. He's a very cerebral athlete.
Yes.
His game planning is just masterful. The way he picks apart his opponents, and that match against Gustavo Ballart was just pure technique. Perfection.
That match blew my mind, Mitch, because Tatsumitsu Wada is an expert on the ground. He's got phenomenal skills getting it to the ground, and once he's there, he's a finisher. But his ability to adapt in that, I mean, it really highlighted how much of a veteran he is, and I think sometimes people forget that this man actually has one more professional fight than DJ does. So with that being said, I mean, he is not a novice. He knows how to adapt his style to beat whoever is standing in front of him. So it's going to be a big test for DJ tonight, but a very exciting one.
It'll be interesting to see what kind of game plan he can come up with to take on the greatest of all time, Demetrious Mighty Mouse Johnson. But on the other side of the bracket, the King returns, Danny Kingad, to face Lightning Reece McLaren. This is a stylistic matchup that could not have been scripted. This is perfect for the other side of the bracket.
Oh, I can't wait. This is another great matchup between two high-level competitors. You know, Kingad is very aggressive. He knows no quit. He has no stopping point. He has no boundaries, and he doesn't hesitate whatsoever. He will attack submissions. He will throw from every single angle, and he's always keeping his opponent guessing.
I think Kingad also has some of the best wrestling of the entire Team Lakai squad. Don't hate me, the rest of you guys, but I think Kingad's legit offensive wrestling, but he's going to have to use it defensively because Reece McLaren is something special on the ground. The BJJ black belt has a smooth double leg, and if you get on the ground with him, you're in trouble.
Yeah, you know, Reece McLaren loves to be on the ground. That's where he is the most comfortable. So if he does end up there, I think Reece McLaren is really going to shine. So I think for Kingad, you know, it's a matter of, as you mentioned, using that wrestling defensively. But both these guys are finishers, and this should be an epic matchup. And I really think it depends who implements their game plan first.
And also on this card, we've got the final semifinal. in the Lightweight World Grand Prix, as we have two former world champions going at it on this side of the bracket in what I call the fans' main event, as Eduard the Landslide Folayang takes on one of the greatest of all time, the Underground King Eddie Alvarez. Let's find out what his thoughts are about this huge matchup in his opponent's hometown.
Yeah, I think Eduard is a great competitor, very well-rounded, very athletic, and like you said, he's a national hero of the Philippines. So moving forward, I just know that having a close fight or a decision is not to my liking. I have to go in, I have to go for the finish, and I have to go after him. So this has to be a high-pace, aggressive fight, and that's only going to make good things for the fans. I'm not here for a decision. I'm here to finish my opponent, and hopefully we both get home safe and we have a good fight.
It's really a huge motivation for me, fighting in your home soil. Your family, your friends, and your countrymen is there to support you. I think it adds a good motivation for me to do my best and to give all that I have prepared for this bout.
Oh, Eduard versus Eddie, Misha.
I'm not kidding, I'm getting goosebumps. I'm not joking about that. Every time this bout comes up, I literally am so excited for this, because the Underground King, he's marching into enemy territory and he knows that, but I really feel like his nickname says it all, right? He is the Underground King. He's used to being the underdog, and he thrives in that. And then Eduard Flying, you know, he thrives off of the support of his whole country. He's a hero here, and he loves fighting in front of his hometown.
This one is gonna be, is it gonna come down to wrestler versus striker, or are we gonna see Eddie just reach down deep, put his hands up, and just start throwing?
Look, you know what? It really is going to boil down to Eddie not having a slow start in this. I think that he's spot on with that he needs to bring this to Folayang, because Folayang is from bell to bell. He is fast-paced and he is ferocious. And if you're not ready to meet that kind of power, it could be early. But I think Eddie Alvarez is wrapping his mind around that now, that he needs to come out. That both these guys are so well-rounded. For me to say that one style beats another, you know, look. You know, Eduard Folayang here, he's got these spinning attacks, he's got these crazy things that he does, very unorthodox. It's just going to be an incredible matchup, Mitch.
This is going to be a huge card, ladies and gentlemen, but the main event is what has the world on pause, as Martin Nguyen defends his featherweight world title against Koyomi Matsushima for the featherweight strap. But then in the co-main event, we've got two titles coming up. In the co-main event, we've got the other one, the Flyweight Muay Thai World Championship, as the General Jonathan Haggerty takes on Iron Man Rodtang Jitmuangnon for the Flyweight Muay Thai World title. We've got both semifinals coming up for you guys. We've got Demetrious Mighty Mouse Johnson taking on the sweeper Tatsumitsu Wada. And on the other side, we've got the King, Danny Kingad, taking on Lightning Reece McLaren. But then we've got the final semifinal of the Lightweight World Grand Prix, as the Landslide Eduard Folayang takes on the Underground King Eddie Alvarez. The winner of that will face Sagit Gusein Arsalan Aliyev in the finals in Japan at One Century. And I know everybody is looking forward to that one.
Yeah, I'm just so proud of how you said that name, man. That's a mouthful right there, Mitch.
Yeah, that's going to be a great matchup. I don't know what's going to happen. There's been so much drama that's happened in this tournament format already. So many people, so many moving pieces.
Yes.
You know, that's why we have the alternate bout. We've also got that alternate bout tonight. We've got Jehei Eustaquio facing Yuya Wakamatsu in the reserve bout for the flyweight tournament. So just in case something happens. But, man, this card.
I can't wait. I literally feel like I need to get up and shadow box or something. It's like I have all this energy. I cannot wait for this card. I am beyond excited. I think it's going to be a meltdown in Manila, as our friend Mitch would say.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dawn of Heroes is everywhere. Please check your local listings. We're going broadcasting live to over 140 countries. Singapore, Vietnam, Thailand, India. Hotstar's got a huge deal with us. Can't wait for that. But the USA, check us out on BR Live. And then here in the Philippines, ABS-CBN Sports in Action. You do not want to miss this, ladies and gentlemen.